Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to dive into one of the coolest features from Apple, iPhone mirroring. If you ever wanted to control your iPhone directly from a Mac, this feature is going to blow your mind. So let's get started. The first thing you need to make sure you have latest version of iOS, which is macOS. Also, you need to make sure your iPhone is on version of iOS, which is iOS 18. At the time of both devices need to be signed in with the same Apple ID. To start your iPhone mirroring, you go to Mac or open Spotlight and search for iPhone mirroring application. Now, as you can see, it is trying to connect automatically to my iPhone 12 because I've already signed in. But if it's your first time, you will need to unlock your iPhone and authenticate the connection using Touch ID or your password or your Face ID. Once connected, your iPhone screen will appear on your Mac. You can now interact with your iPhone using your Mac mouse, auto track, and a keyboard. It's like having your iPhone right on your Mac. Currently, my iPhone is on charge, but let's say if I want to look at some of the application, for example, usually I sign in with some of the application using Authenticator, and I need to get access to my iPhone and, you know, get the code from there. But now with this feature, I can actually just use the iPhone mirroring and open the Authenticator application and just copy paste. One of the best parts about the iPhone mirroring is the privacy and security. Your iPhone stays locked, so no one else can access it while you are mirroring. Plus, the connection automatically pauses after the period of inactivity. Let's take a look at some of the options how we interact with the iPhone using iPhone mirroring. You can tap, swipe, and type. So you can use your mouse. If you want to swipe between pages, you can click and swipe right with the mouse, or if you have a trackpad, just use your two finger and swipe left and right. If you have a mouse with a scroll wheel, you can hold the shift key and scroll up or down to swipe right or left. I'm going to open my Chrome browser on an iPhone, and let's say if I want to go back to the home screen, you can actually take your mouse up and you will see this button there, right there. Click on it and then you'll go back to the home screen. To open the apps, click here and you'll see all the apps, and you can click and swipe up to kill the app. You can open Spotlight by pressing Command 3 or clicking on this search button. Let's say you play the music on your iPhone, your Mac speaker will be used for all the sound. There are a couple of options available for resizing your iPhone. So if you go to View menu bar, you can choose from actual size, smaller, or larger. Currently, I'm using larger. So if you go to actual size, this is your actual size of your iPhone. You go smaller, you can also go larger. In terms of notification, after your iPhone mirroring connects to your Mac automatically receives notification from your phone. It receives them whether or not you're using iPhone mirroring or your iPhone is nearby. As long as your iPhone is turned on, you can manage these notifications from either device. One of the cool features of iPhone mirroring is ability to copy items between devices. You can use universal control to copy content from your device, use AirDrop to your Mac, or AirDrop to your iPhone, use iCloud Drive to share content. So for example, one of the settings that I want to show you is if you go to iPhone mirroring, go to settings, and you want to basically make sure that the automatic authentication is turned on. If you remember the start of the video, when I started iPhone mirroring, my iPhone was automatically authenticated. That's because when I set it up, I selected this option, automatic authenticate. So make sure you do that as well. You don't need to type your password or use Touch ID every time you connect to iPhone. Mirroring is my favorite feature of new macOS and new iOS 18, because a lot of times when I was trying to sign into various web services or application, I usually authenticate them with Authenticator, which is usually installed on an iPhone, like Microsoft Authenticator or Google Authenticator. I always had to go and open it on iPhone and then copy the code from there. But now I can keep this running on a side, and anytime I need Authenticator code, I can simply copy from the iPhone and then paste it where I want. So this is one of the coolest features that I'm using this pretty much every day. Last thing I would like to say that this has some requirement as well. These are the requirements for iPhone mirroring. Your computer must be with Apple Silicon or Apple T2 security chip. Your iPhone is using iOS 18 or later. Your iPhone and a Mac are also signed in with the same Apple account using two-factor authentication. Your iPhone and a Mac have both turned on Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. Your iPhone is locked and nearby. It can also be charging. Your iPhone is not sharing its cellular connection. Personal hotspot is not in use. Your Mac is not sharing its internet connection or using AirPlay or a sidecar. To be able to use iPhone mirroring, you need to make sure all of these are valid. Thanks you so much for watching the video. If you like the content, please subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in the next one.